The new 14-inch MacBook Pro model looks like it'll be an evolution of the new MacBook Pros that we have right now. However, what will change for the next generation MacBook Pro? Well, today we're going to look into what the MacBook Pro M2 Pro and Max chipset is going to give us, and I'm also going to give you the latest details of everything we know so far, including the MacBook Pro 2023 release date and price spec summary. So every MacBook now has an Apple Silicon chipset inside it, and the last MacBooks to get this were the brand new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros with that M1 Pro and M1 Max chipset inside. Now already a lot of us are wondering, what will the next generation Mac Pro give us in the likes of 2022 or 2023? Well, in this video I'm going to cover over everything we know so far for the brand new higher spec MacBook Pros that Apple will release in the future. So if you watch some of my videos already, you will know I'm going to give you the latest details from specific reports of info that we've been told, then the details of the planned release date, then a summary of the models that are going to be released with all the features that we have learnt in previous leaks as well. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the next generation MacBook Pro. Also, put in the comments below of what features you would love to see in the MacBook Pros, and maybe in my next video I will feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So let's get started with the main details of the next generation 14-inch MacBook Pro. So right away, let's get the elephant in the room out of the way, and that's to do with the design of the brand new MacBook Pro coming out in 2022 or 2023. It is most likely that Apple will probably not do any changes to the main design of the 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pro, except for a few tiny tweaks of updated corrections that current users of the current M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBook Pros may be reporting. Apple tends to keep the same MacBook design for a good few years before they change it again. For example, back in 2008 when the unibody MacBook Pro came along, Apple upgraded the chipsets, hard drives and other parts put inside the main MacBook Pro, but the main overall design didn't change until the Retina MacBook Pros in 2012, and then this happened again with hardly any changes until we got the touch bar design MacBook Pros in 2016, with the same happening all over again until we've got these brand new Apple Silicon MacBook Pros that we have today. So as you can see, the design is always around for 4 to 5 years coverage, but Apple do change the insides of these MacBook Pros. A good example of where some small changes, minus chipsets, RAM and hard drives, may happen is, for example, with the Touch Bar MacBook Pros. And they originally came with the butterfly keyboards in 2016. And as you know, if you've owned one of these MacBook Pros all the way to 2018, they were plagued with problems. So what Apple did in 2019, they brought out a brand new Magic Keyboard mechanism that worked completely different to the butterfly keyboard, but on the surface, if you actually compared the looks of say a 2018 MacBook Pro to a 2019 MacBook Pro keyboard, they didn't look any different. But like I said, the actual keyboard worked very differently underneath. Like I said, it is most likely, if we're expecting any changes from Apple on the newly designed MacBook Pros, it will be small tweaks like this one with like the keyboard, for example, even though the keyboard is great on the M1 Pro and the M1 Max MacBook Pros. However, we'll be getting upgraded chipsets inside the MacBook Pros, will include the M2 Pro and the M2 Max chipsets, and I'll be covering more details about these in an upcoming video. But for now, the main thing to take away is the actual design of the MacBook Pros are probably not going to really change for the next release, except for underneath the hood, where we're going to be getting that brand new M2 Pro and M2 Max chipsets. I also want to comment at this stage into the video that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof they will come true with the new MacBooks. Like I have said before in many of my other videos, I can only present to you what has been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the new MacBooks anyway. So the next question is on the release date. So with Apple's journey complete with equipping every Mac with an Apple Silicon M1 variant chipset inside, apart from the Mac Pro, but that is not likely to get an M1 variant chipset, but that's a story for another day. It's very likely that these chipsets will probably get replaced in the same order that they came out with the M1. So I'm talking about the initial M2 to first of all come out, then to get the chipset of the M2 Pro and the M2 Max, and then finally the M2 Ultra. So with this in mind, the M2 journey will probably start now in fall of 2022. So we could see the M2 appearing in the likes of the iMac 24 inch, the iPad Pro, the Mac Mini, the MacBook Air, and also the smaller base MacBook Pro, so the replacement for the current 13 inch MacBook Pro. This means that the M2 Pro and the M2 Max will be coming next after these products get upgraded to M2. It is likely again that not all of these devices that had an M1 chipset inside it will be upgraded to M2 all at the same time. So expected that some of these devices will be updated in fall this year with M2, and then there'll probably be some other devices updated to M2 in spring 2023. This would mean that we probably wouldn't see the updated M2 Pro and the M2 Max chipsets in the likes of the MacBook Pros inside them until at least fall 2023. However, there is the possibility of seeing the M2 Pro chipset in the likes of the second generation iMac 24 inch model or even the new design Mac Mini. So it is possible that the release of the MacBooks could be before fall of 2023, but it's unlikely that you will see any of them in 2022. So, just quickly guys, this channel recently got over 350,000 subscribers, what's absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I am doing a giveaway right now on this channel for this. It is for a MacBook Air, and this MacBook Air here is the 8-core GPU option with 512 gigabytes of storage, and I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 400,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear or what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. And when we get over that 400,000 subscribers marker, I'll be creating a video on this channel announcing who the winner is. So if you are new here, make sure to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell right now. Now, just quickly, I do want to mention there are lots of scammers, there are lots of spammers, a lot of them impersonating myself, and they're telling you to WhatsApp you or to WhatsApp them or to Telegram them. Ignore them completely or report them, because this is not me. Like you've heard from me here, I'll be making a video when we get over 400,000 subscribers announcing any kind of giveaway on this channel, and it will definitely be this time for this MacBook Air here. Well, with that out of the way guys, let's return back to the video. With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far that previous leaks have painted the picture of what details the new MacBook Pros will give us with their baseline price as well. So starting out with the MacBook Pro 14 inch with the M2 Pro and M2 Max chipset inside it. It will be very similar, as I've already said in other parts of this video. So we'll be getting a 14 inch XDR Retina display, which is a mini LED display with a resolution of 3024 by 1964. And this is a ProMotion adaptive refresh rate display with 120 Hz or up to 120 Hz, like what we have right now with the M1 Pro and M1 Max 14 inch MacBook Pros. Storage will be very similar again, we'll have 512 gigabytes all the way up to 8 terabytes. Inside it for chipset, we'll get that M2 Pro and M2 Max chipset. And this will be an option of an 8 or 10 core option. So if you go with the lowest spec M2 Pro, you'll get 8 cores, but if you go for the standard M2 Pro and also if you get the M2 Max, you'll get a 10 core CPU. And the same again for the GPU, it depends. So if you go for that lower spec M2 Pro, the first sort of baseline model, you'll get a 14 core GPU, but it goes up to 16 core and then up to 24 cores, then 32 core GPU. And this depends on what you pick with either an M2 Pro or you get yourself the M2 Max. Very similar to what we have right now with the M1 Max and the M2 One Pro. For RAM, there isn't going to be much differences in the next generation of this MacBook Pro. You'll get the option of either 16, 32 or 64 gigabytes of RAM. And a lot of you out there will know if you've got the M1 Pro or the M1 Max that 16 gigabytes of RAM inside this machine compared to say 16 gigabytes of RAM in an Intel MacBook Pro, you will know this is very different indeed in how this is handled. So 16 gigabytes is really quite enough for quite a lot of people out there. The body again will be an aluminium body, and then for ports wise we will get the MagSafe, we'll get the 3 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, HDMI 2.1 and then also an SD card slot as well. Then for the webcam in that notch in the middle, it's likely it's going to be upgraded to a center stage webcam at last, and that will also be a 1080p camera. For battery life, because of efficiencies in that M2 Pro and M2 Max chipset, we will probably get a slightly larger battery life. We will actually now get 18 hours instead of the 17 hours. But for price wise, the baseline MacBook Pro, we will probably get an M2 Pro. This is one with the 8-core CPU and 14-core GPU with 16GB of RAM and 512GB of storage. Will start at probably around the same price that we have right now, what is $1,999. So that is a summary of the new MacBook Pros. However, for my thoughts and wishes, well, my thoughts and wishes are to do with actually the current M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBook Pros. I am hoping that when the new M2 Pro and Max comes out, that Apple still sells the M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBooks, but at a lower price. I am thinking something along the lines of what Apple do right now with iPhones. So each year when a new iPhone comes out, we still sell, or Apple still sell, a variant of the last generation or two of those models of the last generations for a bit less than what they were a year ago. I would love to see this happen to the M1 Pro and the M1 Max MacBook Pros, as they are such amazing devices and will be for many, many years to come. I would hope that the 14-inch base model, for example, would be reduced to say $1,799 compared to the M2 Pro base model that will be probably about the same at $1,999 that we pay right now for the current model. Do you think this would be a good idea? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below whether you agree with this or not. And also, let me know what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Pros. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon.